5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Buckle up, it's our annual urine review edition of the program.
That is one of the biggest bullcrap statements I've ever heard in my entire life.
Still in disbelief.
Everybody can take a deep breath and relax.
Are you ready to take that deep breath? You'll need it as we dissect the biggest news stories and newsmakers of 2021.
This is not being recorded now, is it?
It hurts. Still break.
America has lost one of our greatest patriots.
I'm happy to announce tonight that I am running for the United States Senate.
I am unafraid, and I'm not going to back down.
We have a strict dress code. There are no masks at all permitted.
No vaccine passports, no vaccine mandates for COVID, and no more lockdowns, okay? Let's get this real straight.
Our numbers are increasing.
Delta, Delta, Delta.
At the moment, we're in a crisis.
We're not in crisis mode.
We will finally axe the food tax.
Just because I do not want critical race theory taught to my children in school does not mean that I'm a racist, damn it.
We are conducting an internal process for where we play, and one of those options is to play downtown baseball.
It's Patrick Mahomes' favorite burger, and we love him.
I'm angry about all this violence in this city.
The end result we want is Chief Smith gone.
That'll have to wait until next year. What else can we expect in 2022? This week, we're also bringing out the crystal ball to predict what you can expect in this brand spanking new year.
How could I be any more excited?
Go Chiefs! Let's get them in 2022! Woo!
Week in Review is made possible through the generous support of AARP Kansas City, Dave and Jamie Cummings, Bob and Marlise Gorley, the Courtney S. Turner Charitable Trust, John H. Mize and Bank of America N.A., co-trustees, and by viewers like you. Thank you.
It is a holiday miracle. Welcome, I'm Nick Haines. Your eyes are not deceiving you. We are here, back in the flesh. We're about to find out that the star's Dave Helling is not just a digital image. He's a living, breathing human being. Casey, while Steve Kraske is not a disembodied head on a Zoom screen, he's got real arms and legs, and they move, don't they? Okay. KNBC Radio's Dana Wright is with us, and she's put on makeup and pants as she makes her return to television. And The Call's Eric Wesson has come out of his concrete bunker and dressed up for us on this Yuletide edition of the program. Doesn't it feel kind of odd?
It feels wonderful.
Oh, it feels good.
It feels great.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
we've got a lot of fun things to go through. Remember, on our Year in Review edition of the program, we go through the best and worst of the year in game show style. Steve Kraske, we begin with a multiple choice question for you. Of all the stories making news in Kansas City over the past year, what was the story that had the greatest impact on our metro? Now, before you answer, here's some options for you to consider.
Was it continuing pushback over vaccines and mask mandates?
The masks are a joke.
Or was it the clash over school boards, from COVID restrictions to the teaching of race? Or was it the dispute over police funding in Kansas City, which dominated the headlines for most of the year? Or was it the overwhelming disappointment back in February as the Chiefs lose the Super Bowl? Or the latest headlines that Kansas City could soon lose Cerner, its largest private employer? Or was it Kansas City's largest traffic jam as Whataburger comes to town?
You haven't tasted nothing yet.
Alrighty, Steve, did you pick one of those stories or something completely different?
You know, I picked one of those, and I don't know about my colleagues, Nick, but I'm just overwhelmed looking back at what a year this was in terms of the volume of news and the significance of so much of that news. But I picked the pushback over vaccines and masks. You know, I think, you know, 50 years from now, historians are going to look back at us and think, what on God's green earth was going on across America during this time when COVID was on the rise again? That fight continues to this day. It's white hot. It's not going away anytime soon.
Dana Wright.
Yeah, I chose A and B because I don't think you can have the school board battle without the vaccine mask pushback. I think they go hand in hand, unfortunately. I agree with you. We all look like fools. I've said this from the beginning. I think the children are the ones handling this better than any of the adults.
And it's been, acting like children.
Yes, the adults are acting like children. It's been an absolute embarrassment. And now we have Times Square is on the bubble this year. They're shutting down Hamilton. A bunch of people are getting sick on a cruise ship. Who saw that coming? Everyone. Because people can't abide by the rules. It's maddening.
Eric.
I chose the guilty plea for the detective in the Cameron Lamb homicide or murder. I chose that because it was the first time that a police officer in this area had even been challenged or been attempted to be held accountable. And the defunding, that they called it, of the police department, that was a hot topic because that forced the conversation we're hearing now with the police budget.
Dave.
All good choices, but I picked the expansion of Medicaid in Missouri with the greatest impact long term. Mm-hmm. A court ordered Missouri to fund Medicaid expansion that was approved by voters earlier. That means that hundreds of thousands of Missourians will be eligible for health insurance and health coverage and will be healthier as a result. And the court also pointed out that the rule of law still exists in Missouri, that the legislature can't simply ignore what the voters wanted and not pay for it. Those are two good developments, and that's the biggest impact in the year.
Eric Wesson, next up, we're picking our person of the year in Kansas City. Are you ready? Before you answer, here are some options for you to consider.
Time magazine just named Tesla founder Elon Musk as its person of the year. But who should be Kansas City's person of the year? Is it this man, Patrick Mahomes, who arguably healed more divides and brought more joy to our city than anyone else this year? Or is it the history maker, Tyrone Garner, who upended politics in Wyandotte County to become the first black mayor of Kansas City, Kansas? Or is it Kevin Strickland, finally free after 43 years and thrust into the national spotlight as a painful reminder of the flaws in our criminal justice system? Or is it the man the Kansas City Chamber named Kansas Cityan of the Year, new Royals owner John Sherman, who's reigniting talk of a downtown ballpark? Or is it the owners of our newest sports team, the KC Current, building a splashy riverfront soccer stadium using their own cash and refusing public subsidies?
Excellent choices here, excellent options. Which did you choose, Eric?
I chose Kevin Strickland. 43 years for something that you didn't do. The politics that were involved in it with the attorney general's office, the governor saying, hey, we're going to keep him locked up. During this period of time from May to August, his mother died, and then he's finally released. You know, one of the interesting things about it was I had always asked, what does the attorney general's office and the governor knows that nobody else knows to drag his case out again? And then to have the positive spirit that he had in forgiving people. I was there when he walked around Royal Stadium barefoot, and he said, hey, if I get out, these are the things I wanted to do, and the Royals owners made it possible for him to have lunch out at the stadium and walk around the stadium barefoot.
Yeah. Dana.
As much as you all want to feel good about just his release and all of these experiences that he now has, it just blew open that gaping hole that is the flawed system of justice that we enjoy. It's the best system in the world, but it is a human system. And why is it when we get it wrong, we get it so wrong?
So,
and it is so hard to correct. It's so hard for politicians to say, we screwed up, we kidnapped this man, which is what this was, for 43 years. We're sorry, we'll pay you, but wait, we don't even have a mechanism to do that. We have so much more to do. And Kevin Strickland is not the only one out there. It is important to remember that there are other Kevin Stricklands out there with also a difficult path to freedom and then no path for compensation in Missouri unless there's some CSI episode involved where there's DNA involved.
Yeah. Did you pick Kevin Strickland or somebody else, Dave?
I did not. Usually at this segment, Nick, on the show, I remember people who have passed. And this was an extraordinarily sad year in that regard. Of course, Senator Bob Dole, as we all know, passed away a few weeks ago. But also Dennis Moore, former congressman from the 3rd District in Kansas, Burdette Loomis, who was a great friend to some of us who cover politics in Kansas at the University of Kansas, and then Carol Coe. Carol Coe passed away. She was an extraordinarily interesting local politician. She made a huge impact on City Hall, and she, along with the other people I mentioned, will be missed, and those are the persons of the year for me.
You got a crowded Time magazine cover when you do that.
Yes,
Steve.
I pick someone different, but someone that we all know well, and that's Mayor Quentin Lucas, Nick. For the second year in a row, no one in our community makes news as consistently as Quentin Lucas does. And this year on so many big, meaty, important issues, police budgets, COVID, housing. He was involved from day one on all those issues. He's having a huge impact every day in the metro.
You know, for a lot of years on this program, we would ask, who has the hardest job in Kansas City? And almost every year, people said it was the superintendent of the Kansas City School District. Dave Helling, who has the toughest job in 2021? Was it the police chief? A school board member? Remember, they don't get paid nothing whatsoever, unlike teachers. A public health director, and as you know, most of our local ones quit, retired, or were fired this year. Or was it the traffic control officer outside of Whataburger?
Whataburger was not involved.
Okay.
School board member or school board personnel are at the top of the list. They've had to endure just enormous invective for an entire year, undeserved for the most part. But I wrote down the next police chief. It isn't Rick Smith that has the toughest job in Kansas City. It will be his replacement, who will take over a department that is certainly demoralized, in some ways at war with some people at City Hall, and with the our whole notion of policing changing in Kansas City, Nick. The next police chief, him or her, will have an enormous, enormous difficult job, enormously difficult job going forward.
Did you pick the police chief, Eric?
Yes, I did. And Dave was in my head. the difference that I have with it was the next chief of police, but this guy here, Rick Smith, you got north of the river saying you're a great guy, stay in there. Yeah. You got south of the river saying you're a bum, get out of there. And in the middle, you have to get up and look at yourself in the mirror every morning and say, am I doing the most effective job possible? And then come out and act like none of the stuff that's going on around him is happening.
Yeah. And every single day he went into work, people were asking, you've got to go. You need to resign. Right. Yeah. Wait on his family over that. Yes, Dana.
I chose not only the school board folks, but also anyone crafting or enforcing mask policy. We have had city council members, school board members punched in the face. I said the other day on our show, who in their right mind right now would raise their hand to serve in a local capacity? And in that vein, I'm going to add the flight attendant. My God, it's like an MMA fight up in the air right now. Anyone in charge of enforcing the rules that they did not create while many adults around them act a fool.
Well, Steve. I'm going to tag on to what Dana said. Public health directors, Nick, these folks, how do you fight crazy, for one thing? And secondly, when you're being threatened with your life, for enforcing the rules and the science that these folks have been taught to believe and enact in their own communities, and they're being threatened with their own lives, that makes it a pretty tough job.
Dana Wright, complete the sentence. The biggest winner in Kansas City this year was blank.
Soccer. I'm going with soccer, and I didn't even ever watch soccer until I watched Ted Lasso, and I love you, Ted Lasso, and I love you, Jason Sudeikis. If you look overall at Kansas City in the picture right now, the smash success of our own Jason Sudeikis' Ted Lasso, the KC Current, the changing of the riverfront with the women's team coming in, the excitement around the women's team, and then let's bring in the World Cup, which not sure if we're going to get it, but I hope that we do. I was riding on the streetcar yesterday. Signs everywhere. We want the World Cup. Kansas City is now a soccer town, and I am a fan. I'm a fake fan with Ted Lasso, and I'm a real fan with the women.
All righty, Steve, the biggest winner was who?
Construction companies, Nick, in the wake of Joe Biden's trillion-dollar infrastructure bill. Every construction company in our community is going to benefit and benefit mightily as a result of that new law.
Dave Helling.
I wrote down Kevin Strickland, released from custody. The shame that attaches to Mike Parson and Eric Schmidt for keeping this man in custody when they could have released him will be everlasting. It will be a stain on their memories. Kevin Strickland was the winner.
The biggest winner for you, Eric?
KC Tennis. They got another win last week. They've had wins all year. LGBT community, they made them reconstruct City Hall and men's restrooms, women's restrooms. Now they're everybody's restrooms.
Well, what about then, fill in the blank for me, Steve, the biggest loser in Kansas City in 2021 was blank.
Easy one for me, Nick. Eric Schmidt, the Missouri Attorney General, for enforcing mask mandates and going against those. And then the Kevin Strickland thing, just to piggyback on what Dave said, this is a guy who I don't think really believes what he's doing. This is a guy who's running for higher office, and he's playing politics here. And this is beyond the rules of the game, any rules of the game that I've ever known.
Biggest loser, Dana?
He is a horrible human being. I will just state as a fact. I chose, in a roundabout way, anyone in need of mental health services, particularly teenagers right now. If you look, therapists call Kansas City a black hole when it comes to teenagers needing help with addiction, anxiety, suicidal ideation and tendencies, things like anorexia, bulimia. We are a black hole. If you ask any parent who has gone through this, they scratch their head. Why aren't there any services here? There are parents spending tens of thousands of dollars to ship their kids to Arizona, Colorado, California to get help for their children. We do not have it here. The pandemic has made all of that worse for kids who are already struggling.
Eric.
I chose the petition drive people that tried to recall the mayor, lost. Eric Bunch, lost. The whole at-large council, lost. They have to be the biggest losers of the year.
Dave Helling.
That's a very good pick. Very good pick. But I wrote down Josh Hawley, who raised his fist on January 6th and may have played a role in the insurrection at the Capitol in a way that deserves the condemnation and the understanding of every Missourian. Think back to January 6th, Nick, and how all of us were just shocked beyond belief about what we saw on television. Josh Hawley was in the middle of it.
Eric Wesson, a fill-in-the-blank question for you. The most overreported story in our metro this year was blank.
I couldn't think of any. I thought they were all balanced. I didn't
see So you were fine with Whataburger coming in and all of the hoopla?
Whataburger.
All right,
I mean,
that was fine. How about you, Dave?
Well, I wrote down Whataburger as well.
How about you, Steve?
Oh, he's not through.
Oh, my goodness.
The most overreported
He's taking
story.
Up the Eric Wesson
time.
And
I was involved in this, so I'm calling a foul on myself, by the way. The KCI concessions contract, which, as you remember, was a huge battle in the middle of the summer. I wrote one story on it and thought that would be the end of it, and Mayor Lucas reacted so aggressively about any potential criticism of what was going on that contract that he invited more scrutiny, and by God, he got it. We got a lot of mileage out of that story.
The most overreported story, Nick, you need to get a vaccine, and it still didn't work. The boost, you need to get a booster shot now. That's not playing out very well either, because the numbers are still so low. Unbelievable that people aren't adhering to all this great advice out
there. Dana, what did you put down?
I went with one too well-known brother of our beloved Patrick Mahomes. I'll just leave it at that.
All righty. Dave, complete the sentence. The most underreported story of the year was what?
Well, I had a long list to hear, too, as well, but I put down downtown baseball, and here's why. I think it's more cooked into the books than people know. That all of the talk about it was, well, we're studying it, well, we're thinking about it. If you could get some of these folks on truth serum, the drawings are being made, the tax proposal is being crafted. This thing is going to the public in the next couple of years.
Eric.
That's why it was underreported.
I think COVID positive tests in schools, where you have schools that have classrooms that are being quarantined, and the fact that our kids are behind. You know, they had a whole year and a half of online virtual learning. Now they're in a classroom. Those kids are behind, and I think we don't focus on that enough.
Dana, what did you put down as the underreported story of the year?
You know what, I'm gonna ding the media a little bit on this. We reported in a timely, factual manner that all of the Afghan refugees were coming to Kansas City, and it was exciting, this is gonna be great. And then that story, by and large, dropped off the map.
That's true.
And they have not had the easiest transition coming to our town. There's overcrowding, there's threats of eviction. The Kansas City started a great piece on this back in November. We need to do a better job of not just splashing the headline when something like this happens, but then following up and saying, hey, holding people accountable who said, we're gonna take these refugees in, holding them accountable and saying, okay, where are they staying? How are they doing here? And I feel like the media as a whole should have paid more attention to the aftermath of that.
Steve.
What are we going to do about homicides in our community, Nick? The Star, KCUR have taken looks at this, but everyone is weary of this story. No one really quite knows what to do, but there are different strategies that are out there that need to be looked at and implemented. We've all walked away from this thing. We've got to take another look.
Dana, our next section is called Pick a Gift. It sounds simple enough. You are responsible for giving a gift to one metro area public figure this holiday season. But who would receive the gift when they open that wrapping paper? What is the gift they're going to receive?
I chose for the Attorney General Eric Schmidt and Governor Parsons an ethics class, a heart, and a mirror so they can take a long look at themselves and ask themselves, why did I get into public service?
Dave.
I think that Eric Schmidt could use an ethics course, but he has to wait until he opens my gift for Eric Schmidt and Derek Schmidt in Kansas, and that's a one-way ticket, all expenses paid, to any place in the world they'd like to go, except Missouri and Kansas, and stay there for a year.
I'm going to take Eric Schmidt down to the nearest Target store and buy him a can of Ambition Remover and spray it all over him, which will hopefully give him a sense of some common sense again and get his head back in the game where it needs to be.
They actually have that in aisle 9 in Target.
Thank you. That's where we're going. Aisle 9.
Blue Light Special.
There we go.
We've looked at the twists and turns and highs and lows of 2021. What can we expect as we start this new year together? Steve, complete the sentence. I don't own a crystal ball, but if I did, this is what I'd see happening in our metro in 2022.
We are going to pick an outsider for Kansas City Police Chief, Nick. There's no question about it. It's been since the 1970s, the mid-1970s, with Joe McNamara, since this community had an outsider come in and reassess and take a new look at the way we police ourselves. That's what's going to happen in 2022.
Dana Wright, what did you put down?
Sadly, I believe a continued mass exodus of good teachers. There's only so much any human being can take at the rate that we pay them. In the state of Missouri, we are 50th out of 50. Think about that. We are at the very dead last in what we pay our teachers. You combine the pandemic with parents acting like a fool. I fear we are going to lose more good teachers in 2022.
Eric.
I put on mine in 2022, Kansas City, Missouri is going to have an NBA basketball team come into town for exhibition games.
Oh.
But an NBA team is going to come in here and play an exhibition game, and that's going to lead to us getting our own NBA team.
Wow.
There's a hockey team available in Arizona,
Dave,
by the way, if you're paying attention. My prediction is for a serious multi-week battle over police funding in Kansas City. I've talked to council members. There is enthusiasm for a 20% cap on what they give the police and then negotiating for anything above that. That will be the battle of all battles in Kansas City 1 year before the election.
Now, how much are these predictions worth, by the way? We took a look back at what our panelists said on last year's show. Were they right? You be the judge.
I think once these vaccinations kick in, our town, our country is going to have a rollicking good time for a whole number of years to come.
More pressure on the Chiefs to change that name.
True or false, on February 7th in Tampa, the Chiefs win back-to-back Super Bowls.
True.
True.
Best team in football, they're going to win again.
I'm going to say true. I learned my lesson last year.
All right. It's facing big budget deficits. Kansas finally legalizes medical marijuana.
Kansas will be the last domino to fall, kicking and screaming. And then everyone will say, why didn't we do this earlier?
True or false, the Kansas City Star ceases print edition and becomes an online-only newspaper.
That's true.
Yikes. They're on top of things, aren't they?
Yikes.
So how much weight should we place on our panelists' crystal ball gazing for 2022? We're heading next into our lightning-fast true or false round before the buzzer blows. True or false, Charisse Davids loses re-election in GOP wave.
False. She'll win.
False.
I ground think
that's game. False as well.
Derek Schmidt ousts Laura Kelly as governor of Kansas.
I think true. It's a Republican year. It's a Republican state. It'll be very close. She's going to do much better than people think and could win, but I think Derek Schmidt will.
I agree. It's going to be close.
True or false? Eric Greitens is elected U.S. Senator in Missouri.
False.
Not
true.
Gonna happen.
True.
Yes. No. Yes. We have to get rid of Smith. So we can't have Smith and Holly.
I would say today Eric Schmidt.
Don't go to sleep on Vicki Hartzler. I mean,
I think that's true too.
She's a woman, the only woman in the field. The Republican nominee will win. Likely win. Don't go to sleep on her.
Fill in the blank, Dana. In 2022, blank will close, disappear, or move from our metro.
Ooh, I said, sadly, most big, huge gatherings, cruises, concerts, mask up. I am worried that this is going right on into 2022.
Here's my big hot take prediction. I think there will be a serious move in 2022 for the Northland to de-annex from Kansas City, and it may be enabled by the state legislature. They are really mad up there about the recent decision on dividing the Northland into horizontal districts.
I'm in the Dana Wright camp. Restaurants, this COVID thing is getting serious again. A lot of them are going to shut down, Nick, and it makes me sad on a year-end show to say it.
And I say the same about the restaurants, getting employees to come in and work. We're going to have a lot of restaurants close and pack it up.
True or false, KC Royals drop plans for downtown ballpark. Clearly not, David.
False.
True or false?
They really want it.
We move forward with east-west streetcar line.
True.
Ooh, so we're now finally going to be tailgating on the streetcar going over to Arrowhead Stadium?
It's
going to
be going.
I think it's false.
I think it's false, too. I think it needs to be done and will eventually be done, but not.
I'm not saying it's going to get built. It's going to get talked about.
No, but I mean,
we're
working on
the
Main Street streetcar and the money for that, and it's going to be, we don't want to encourage the people on the east side to think that the streetcar is coming their way anytime soon. It's going to take years.
It's coming.
Years, absolutely.
We're going to be drawing up the planes.
And true or false, the Kansas City Star ceases print edition and becomes online-only newspaper.
No!
True!
False!
True!
No!
I'm going to keep saying it until it happens.
Dave, we didn't get your response to that.
No, false. Well, we're going to keep printing the newspaper, and you're going to keep taking it because it's a good place to get the news.
All right, David. The bell has sounded. We are out of time. You did it. You survived another year in review. Thank you to KC Wild Steve Kraske, the Colts Eric Wesson, the Stars Dave Helling, and she's 50% of Dana and Parks weekday afternoons on KMBZ.
51%.
Dana Wright. Yes, absolutely. Why not? Thanks also, by the way, to our good friend Roberta Solomon, who lent her silky voice to many of our quiz questions this week. And I'm simply your game show host, Nick Haines, from all of us here at Kansas City PBS, where we are right now decking the halls with boughs of holly. Be well, keep calm, and carry on. Merry Christmas, everyone.